I've never had this feeling like someone really loves me, but Jesus truly loves me. It's got my mind reeling. I found the information in lyrics David penned, his savior and his friend, his love without condition. And yeah, I know it sounds improbable, but God, nothing's impossible. God, the same, you never would forsake me. And me, I'm so unfaithful. And God, I don't deserve it. I know you don't deserve it. You see, would I be grateful? Yeah, I know it's not the probable. Without love, that's impossible. God's love. Only everlasting, but God has no beginning. Beyond my comprehension, too wonderful to feel it. Too wild when he's conceiving, and to the top of the. Yeah, I know it sounds improbable, with God nothing's impossible. God's
the other day, me and Clint went dumpster diving at the dumpster down the road, and we found a little wooden canoe, and so we're like, let's send it off with cargo down the river. And so, yeah, I fixed it up with outriggers, which you may notice are small fishing bobbers. And we have some cargo and stuff. And we're gonna launch it from the swimming hole at the river, swimming hole 2, but there's people there! Not to say that people are bad, per se, but you know how people at the swimming hole can interfere with the launching of little canoes. So we're gonna have to try to find another spot. We have moved downstream to the epic, tropic, beautiful location you now see. Perfect. If it wasn't for those people at the swimming hole, we never would have found it. But this is the site of our boat launching. And you might be curious right about now, what's the cargo? Allow Jordan to expound.
Well, the cargo is a $1 million bill. Actually, there's two on board, but this is what they look like. And on the back is the $1 million question, which, to sum it up, is, will you go to heaven? Very important. And thus, we are sending forth a vessel with two of such $1 million question papers to the great beyond. Smell it.
Smell the everlasting riches.
Ooh, smells good.
And we also have a passenger who we picked up on the way on accident, a little inchworm, who I just named Bob. So, he's going along. Let's go launch.
Ow!
I'm trying to come down.
dangerous.
Ow. Ugh.
Okay, Jordan, you can do it. Put the boat in.
I don't know.
You can do it, go on.
No, I can't.
Yeah, just knuckle down.
I can't do it.
Have courage.
No.
Listen to me, Jordan.
I am.
Listen to me. Put the boat in the water. You go. Yes. Good. Good. Now just release.
I can't.
Looks like this isn't a job for an ordinary man, or even a strange man. This is a job for... That is a dog that Jordan discovered unattended on site one. And we don't allow that, do we, Jordan?
No, not at all. Not the tiniest bit.
We do not allow any dogs to be out yonder without their owners around. So, really, the reason I was showing you that dog was that it looked really sad. Its eyes were droopy and it was sad. And I know that you are sad, too, because you missed the launching of our boat. And you know why? You know why you missed it? Because the camera battery died. He passed. He's the late camera battery now. And so we're a little bit sad too. And we'd really like to make it up to you, but we can't. So, why don't you do a little closing epilogue or eulogy or something?
Well, we launched the boat with the good news inside. We were faithful in sowing seeds to the river, and we just have to trust God for the increase and hope that the seeds of life do not fall and crash against stony riverbanks, but fertile riverbanks, where it can sprout into a tree of life.
I would just like to say, from the bottom of my heart, not the top, bottom, coming from down here, with all heartfelt fervor and desire for a snack, I apologize for that part you missed, the most epic moment of the whole video. And there is a way we can overcome this, though. If you want... Yes, there is. What we need is more camera batteries, so if you just want to donate money to the cause...
Why are you in such a... what do you call it? Compromising position?
They say they love me too.